Hello. Today I'm going to show you how to find the product of two numbers written in scientific notation. There are a few things you need to know prior to doing this. First thing is multiplying numbers with negative exponents, and the second thing is scientific notation, which I will be talking about. So, what is scientific notation? It's just a shorter way of showing a giant number using exponents. An example is 4 million, as I have here. It would turn into 4 times 10 to the sixth power. And it would be like that because there is 6 zeros on this, on the 4 million. So it would, so every zero counts as a 10, and that would be 6 tens. So, yeah. I have a problem from a test that I did, and I'm going to show you how to do it. So, you do this, and then that, and then all of these things, and then voila! The answer is 1.5 times 10 to the negative 8th power. Oh, you didn't see it? Okay, then let me show you it again, but this time I'll do it slower. I already have it written out. So, you start out by doing 5 times, so the problem was 5 times 10 to the negative 6th power times 3 times 10 to the negative 3rd power. Now this may seem like a really crazy problem that you'll never figure out, but it's not that hard. You just need to know how to do it. So first, we're going to start out by multiplying these two, the 3 and the 5 together. And we get 5 times 3 equals 15. Then we do 10 to the negative 6th power times 10 to the negative 3rd power, which equals 10 to the negative 9th power. That would be 15 times 10 to the negative 9th power. And in scientific notation, the number right here, the written number, has to be greater than or equal to 1 or less than 10. So we take that from 9 and get 1.5 times 10 to the negative 8th power. Now, I have a few questions that you may be asking. Some of you might be asking, why do you turn 15 into 1.5? And as I just said, 15 cannot be used because it's more than 10. So we would change it, we would take away a 10 and we would add it to the total number. So, yeah. And then my friend asks this question. How do you multiply 10 to the negative 6th power and 10 to the negative 3rd power and get 10 to the negative 9th power? Well, if you wrote it out with all the zeros on it, and then you added those together, you would get 10 to the negative 9th power. So, it's pretty easy. There's a pretty simple way by just adding these exponents together to get the answer. And now that you understand this, I want to quiz you. I have a random problem here that was in a math book, and I'm going to have you pause the video and solve it. It is 6 times 10 to the 7th power times 9 times 10 to the 5th power. Now, go pause the video, get a piece of paper, and solve this. Okay, now that you've done that, let's go over. So you first start out by doing 6 times 9, which would equal 54. Then you do 10 to the 7th power times 10 to the 5th power, which would be 10 to the 12th power. Then you would get 54 times 10 to the 12th power. Then the answer would be 5.4, because 10 is more than 54 is more than 10, so we put take away a 10, and times 10 to the 13th power. And you may be asking, why didn't we take it down? Because this one is not a negative exponent. So, that's how you solve it. I hope I answered any questions you may have had, and I hope you got the similar question right. To go over, you multiply the regular numbers, multiply the exponents, Turn the multiplied number into a decimal if it is under, if it's less, if it's more than 10, and add the number of the new decimal numbers to the exponent and put the numbers together. Thank you and good night, or goodbye. Goodbye.